In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how you can add random colour to objects inside of Maya. This method can be used for mesh objects but also non-mesh objects, and it doesn't include using the mesh random colour node, it's much simpler than that. So let's go into Maya. In this scene I have just some simple cubes to start with, and we are going to work on creating an Arnold shader for them. So if we right click and assign a new material, we are going to assign a standard surface, and then let's give it a name. Where it says base color, you want to click the checkerboard, and then in here we want to start typing jitter and make sure you've got Arnold checked, and the AI color jitter is what we want. So if you click that, that's going to connect, just zoom in, the AI color jitter into your base color. So the AI color jitter is going to control the random color. So what you first want to do is change this input color. If you've got white, it doesn't really work, so you need to make sure that you've got at least a little bit of saturation, but maybe I'm going to start with kind of a yellowy hue here. This is going to be the base color. The type we want to change to object, and then you're mainly going to use the hue min and hue max. We start to bring this down, we can see that it is adding some kind of pink colors to my objects, and then we can push the hue max up and it starts to add a bit more. Now you can play around then with those settings. The more saturated you add here, the more saturated the colors will be up here, and then you can also play with the saturation from here and set a max value. So that's everything there is to it really. If you use the seed option, you can just type in different values and it will randomize how it applies the same setting. So yeah, you just change the seed till you find something that you like and tweak the min and max values to change the kind of different colors that it can pick out from. So that's just applying it to some objects in your scene, but let's say you wanted to apply it to a mesh network. So it's really simple. So if I just go to my perspective view here, hide my cubes and show the base sprinkles. So these were the three different sprinkles that I have plugged into my mesh network. So let's just actually turn the mesh on and just get those to full. There we go. So we can see that currently these base sprinkles, I just select one, just have the lambda on them. But all I would need to do is select these and assign the existing random color, and it automatically applies them to the objects that are using these as instances in mesh. I haven't got a mesh color node in here. I don't have to go through the process of adding data sets. This is the simplest way. Create this random color using the AI jitter and then apply it to the original objects that are driving your mesh simulation.